guys, Mr. PC Electronics here, and today I'm going to show you how to replace an LCD screen on a laptop. This particular model is a Gateway M1624. You probably can't see it from that far, but the screen is really cracked. I mean, it's cracked all over. So, let's get to it. First thing we're going to do is we're going to flip the laptop upside down. We're going to pull the lever on the battery and pull the battery out. After that, we're going to flip open the laptop and we're going to go ahead and pry this panel off. Now you want to start from one side, wedge your fingers underneath the one side, pull up. It kind of feels like it's going to break, but on some models there's screws on the bottom of the laptop that you have to unscrew first. But with this particular model, that's not the case. So we're going to pull up on this side. Now don't pull up too high because this is a metal, little sheet metal. So if you pull too hard, you're going to dent it. All right, so we got that, and we kind of want to pull forward and up like that. And then what we're going to do is we're going to run our finger as we're applying pressure. So just like this. And we're going to do it over here. Just like that. With no broken pins or nothing. Now there's two screws right here and right here on the keyboard. I've already taken them out. Now we're going to put this back in there slightly, close the lid, and with this keyboard, if you start pulling up on your keyboard, you feel it's still tight, like it feels like there's another screw there, more than likely is. So flip it over, and we're going to look on the back, and you want to look for either a K or a little keyboard sign, and sometimes you have to take off a cover, unscrew it, and look under it in the motherboard, and it'll show another little K or keyboard sign. So right here we got a K, so that means it's keyboard. And we're going to unscrew this one right here. And I'll just let it flip out. Now we can pull our keyboard up. Just like that. And if you look right here, that was the screw that was at the bottom of the laptop. So for these, the ribbons right here, all you do is, on this particular one, you just get your flathead and you slide it out. Now, if you want to check out my other videos on how to take the ribbons out, because I have this camera so high so you can get the full visual of what's going on here, go ahead and check out how to change a hard drive. I have a video on that, and it shows real close-ups on how to take these pins out and stuff, and actually how to disassemble a keyboard also. So check that out. All right, so we're gonna slide this pin out. Just pull it out like that. And we're pretty much done with that. We didn't even honestly have to take the keyboard out if we didn't want to, but I just decided to get it out of the way so I could pull this ribbon out. Now this one just flips up. It's just a little piece, it just stick it under there, flip it up, and it comes right out like that. Now, we have three screws right here, or actually two on this side and three on this side, and we're not going to touch them just yet. We have to unplug the LCD screen, and if you look right here to the right, there's an LCD wire pin that goes into the motherboard. Just pull up on it, and that's it for that. Also, you have your antenna wires for your wireless card, the white and black ones. Now you're gonna have to flip the laptop upside down to get to these. So go ahead and close your lid, flip it upside down, and we're gonna have to take off a panel. If you don't know which one it is, just take them both off. So we're looking for a wireless card. This one says PC Express and hard drive, so it's probably not gonna be on that one. This one's the memory. More than likely it's the wireless card is by the memory. But actually this one, here's the wires right here. They go all the way down and they go into where the hard drive is. So we're gonna take these two off, or these three screws. Now keep in mind, every laptop's a little bit different, but this is just the basic tutorial on how to change an LCD screen. Okay, now here is our wireless card right here. We're just gonna pull up on these little antenna wires, and you're gonna wanna stuff them back through. We gotta take all these wires out. So we're gonna push them through and we wanna feed them back to the front of the laptop. So now it's all loose. We're gonna flip the laptop. Try to keep the wires out of the way so you can pull them through. Open them up and slide like a screwdriver under there to get the wire started. And lift up on it a little bit. And there we go. Now we're just gonna feed it around these little catch tabs. Pull up, and now we're ready to take the LCD off. So, now we're just going to unscrew these five screws right here. And we got, I like to dismount the LCD so I don't mess with any of the actual laptop itself. Other components, you know, could get damaged while you're trying to drop the screen in. I like to put it in by itself first. Now you can take off all this and do a swap out, but it's just much easier to lay it flat, work on it, and then put it back together. Three, and we get two more, and then the whole LCD screen should dismount. Now, a lot of people on eBay will sell a whole screen with the framing and everything. So all you have to do is actually this. You just pull off the whole LCD screen with the panel and all, and you're ready to go. So now we're just going to flip it back down, and on the back side of this, these little levers right here, we're gonna have to pop them off. All right, so you just want to pull flathead. Try to honestly use a lot of plastic, like maybe a plastic knife or something, because you can actually damage the plastic very easily. So we're gonna open this down like that. This one seems to be having a little problem, so there we go. Just needs to give a little pop. Sometimes they're a little tricky. See, they're just covers. So we'll set that one aside. We got another one here. And that one's out. And this one is the one that's being a little picky. There we go. Almost. See if we can't get it from the back. There we go. And it's being stubborn, this one. But it happens. There we go. Okay, so we got those off. Now it's not gonna quite come off because we got two more screws. Now, not every laptop has this, but there's one here and one here, and they're the main bracket screws. So we're gonna take those out. They're probably a little bit longer, so you can't really, no, actually these ones are not too bad. About the same size as the rest. And after we do this, the whole LCD screen should come right off. So, there we go, just like that. Now we just got to work our wires through this little catch clip right here, and that's it. Whole LCD screen's off. Now we're ready to strip it down. All right, first things first, get a little tiny flathead, and we're gonna pull off every one of these little rubber stoppers, all of them. There are screws underneath there, and we need to get to them. Now, in order to pry this thing apart, some people use like a real thin piece of plastic or a little kitchen plastic knife, but I'm just gonna go ahead and try to work it with my fingernails. Sometimes you can actually get up under. This one, it really doesn't matter if you damage the screen any more than it already is. It's pretty much damaged to begin with, so there's not gonna be any kind of messing up. So once you get it started, you're just gonna work your finger just a little at a time. It's gonna be a little tough. Don't get me wrong. I mean, these clips don't just barely hold on. So if you can pull at an angle, it'll work a lot better. Some of them feel like they're never gonna give, but they will. And the way these clips are, is actually if you pull it forward, there we go, kind of pull the screen inward because it clips on the outside of the LCD screen. So pull them inward just like that. Push in and up, and they seem to come out a lot better. Now on these ones on the outside, I think it's a little different. It's pushed outward. actually in too. Yeah, push in towards the LCD screen. And there we go. Now, keep in mind, there might be, nope. So that's it. That's it for those. I was thinking maybe that the webcam was connected, possibly. All right, so this screen's toast. We're getting ready to rip it out. Right here is your inverter. And you don't gotta worry about that. If your screen happens to have no backlight, you have a bad inverter. And that's all it is. This right here sends the light to the either LEDs or LCD bulbs. And that's it. Okay, so now we're gonna take out all the screws. We got two here, we got two here, and that's it. So we got four screws we're gonna take out. Take out these two. And on most of them, there's arrows. On this one, there's arrows to every one that's connected to it. Now, once we're done pulling this out, we gotta disconnect this inverter. So. And the last screw. And that's it for that. Now, also we gotta disconnect the, well, the webcam shouldn't worry about it. It's a different cable. So, go ahead and loosen this, or take this screw off on the inverter so it can be relieved of its duty. And we're gonna pull this screen up. Actually take it back. Go ahead and unplug the webcam right here. Just pull out. And that's it. Now, with this LCD screen, it didn't come with a ribbon. So we're gonna have to reuse this ribbon. All right, we're gonna unplug it. And let me see if you can see it. It's very simple. You're gonna pull up on the ribbon. Obviously, take the tape off. I would leave the tape on the ribbon, but just pull it off the LCD screen. Go ahead and unplug from the back of your inverter right here. Grab the actual plastic part and pull it out. That's all there is to that. And we're attached up right here. So this inverter has another plug. Just go ahead and flip it upside down and pull that plug out. Also, we're gonna save this because this is going back in there. Now for the ribbon, just go ahead and peel up the other side of the ribbon. We want all of the ribbon. And right here, you're just gonna pull out. That's pretty much it. There's a piece of tape on this one, so I'm gonna go ahead and just cut the tape with a little flathead screwdriver. Just don't cut any pins. And that's it. Now we're just gonna pull it out and just set that aside. So everything else on this is junk except for the brackets. Now this screen didn't come with a bracket, so we have to use this one. And I would suggest taking out the new one right now. So we're gonna set all this aside. Make sure I don't have any of those yet. Got some screws stuck to it. My little stoppers. All right, set all that aside. Now take your old LCD screen and set it forward. I'm gonna zoom out so you guys probably see this. I don't know, I'm thinking you can't. And just put a piece of plastic under it. And drop it just like that. So you have your new LCD and your old LCD lined up parallel with each other with the boards at the top. And we're just gonna swap out these brackets because you don't wanna get them upside down and then get it all the way in there and have to take them all apart again. So we're just gonna take our Phillips head screwdriver, and there is two screws for this side bracket. So we'll do one bracket at a time. Gonna take this screw off and then this other one right here. And just pull the bracket off and slide it down onto this one. Lift it up. put it in the same exact holes that you had before. And once we're done with this bracket, we're going to do the same exact thing to the other bracket. And I'll just flip this one over since I know the other side is already on there. Take out that one. And we got one more. And then after this, we're going to put it actually in the lid, the top part of the laptop, and be pretty much ready to install it back into the laptop. Now we're going to bring our, move our LCD up here. Bring our back panel lid. And right before we put it in, we're going to flip it upside down. We're going to put our ribbons on. We just put our brackets on. Now the ribbon, you don't want to see, if you look at the ribbon, you do not want to see the teeth. Okay, so the teeth, the gold teeth or pins, you're going to have them facing down. So we're just going to, all you do is line it up with the little slot. And then just push it in, and that's it. Same thing with this. I'm just going to, this is for the webcam. We're just kind of set that there. The tape, I'm going to reuse the tape. I'm just going to push everything in there, tape it back where it was. And that's it. We have our whole LCD screen put back together. We got a ribbon. Our inverter, I just went ahead and plugged the inverter in, makes it easier. Make sure you have all your wires, your antenna wires through where the notches are right here. And we're just gonna lay it in, just like this. Right before we do, forgot, plug in your webcam. See if we can't line it up, there we go. Make sure the wire's out of the way. And just line it up with the screw holes. And make sure your ribbon for your, or not ribbon, your cable for your LCD is out of the way too. And then its grooves. There we go. Feels like it's pushing on something. Oh yeah, right here. There we go. The cable was twisted upside down. And that's it. Now just line up your holes. And there's little plastic guides that guide the LCD screen down. Make sure it's over that. Now that that's done, you only want to put the screws where the arrows are, because we still have to put our trim on. So if you don't know where to put the screws, just follow the holes here and don't put them in wherever these holes are. So we're gonna go ahead and put, looks like we got about six screws we have to put in. Then after this, we're gonna put our inverter in, screw that to the lid. All right, now that we have our screen screwed in, we've got our inverter plugged in. We're just going to move the wires out of the way, and there's a little plastic guide here, and if we can, just like that, and we're going to take our screw and screw the inverter back in place. Need to make sure everything's lined up. They make those little plastic guides just so that it lets you know that that's exactly where it goes. Now we have all our trim on. We're just going to take our screws and we're going to screw it all in, and then after that we're just going to put our little rubber stoppers over the screws, and then we'll be ready to install it on the laptop. Now we have all the screws in, we're just going to take our rubber stoppers and we're just going to put them on there. Now, the bottom ones are going to be a little bit bigger on this model. Now it's time to put it back on the laptop. I'm going to get rid of this. And we'll bring the laptop over here. And you can clean out some of the guides if it's a little dirty. Now all we're doing is just lining it back up. Let's see if I can bend these out a little bit. There you go. You just want to line it up with the ports, the holes right here. This one goes straight down. You really can't mess it up. You're just putting it exactly the way it was on there. Just like that. See if I can bend it down so you can see. And we're going to take the bigger screws. Actually, these were the smaller ones, and then the bigger ones are in the back. And we're just going to screw it down to secure it on there. And after this, we're just going to install our cables, and that should be pretty much it, the keyboard, and we got ourselves a new LCD screen. Alright, so when you're done putting these screws on the main bracket, you're going to close the laptop, and on the back over here, you got two more screws. Now, some laptops probably don't have this, but majority of them do, and that's just an extra support for the bracket. And that's it for that. Now we're going to flip it back over. And we got all our wires feeding through here. So we're going to go ahead and run the antenna wires. And there should be a gap down here, if you can see the hole where we pulled them out originally. Kind of just flip it over and have a good look. So we want to run it through this part right here, and we're going to run it back down through here and to the wireless card. So keep your finger on there, and it's going to be right here. So there's a guide right here that you clip it on, so we run it around here, down through here, because everything has to be flush because we still got to get that panel back on there and everything. So you don't want your panel, sticking up. So put it through there. And if you have to get a screwdriver to jam it back down in there, that's fine. And now we're just going to shove these two down through here. We're going to flip the laptop over a little bit. Run it through down through there. Go ahead, close it. And run it through the channels here. It's kind of like a zigzag effect, like running through cones. And then you run it back down through here. And if you don't do this, you're gonna have wires just sticking out everywhere. This is exactly how it comes from the manufacturer, like this. So now keep in mind, you really can't mess it up. There is no color for color. You know, they're just wires. So whichever one you feel like putting it on, go ahead. It doesn't matter. And then just take the wires and kind of tuck them down in there. And now we're just gonna put the cover back on because we're done with this. We don't need any more. We got our keyboard screw right here. So we'll get to that last. We're just gonna put the covers back on. Screw that in. All right, we'll put our battery in last. Go ahead and open it up. Now we got a couple more cables. We got our cable for the LCD screen. We're just gonna stick it back in our original port. Just line it up. You can't miss it because it has a catch tooth edge that does it right. Alright, now we're going to put our keyboard on. Remember, there's one screw on the bottom. All we're going to do is we got everything plugged in, and we're just going to put our ribbon in. It's very simple. Whichever way the keyboard goes, pull the ribbon down, slide it in like this, and push down on the levers. Lock it in. Then you got little slots right here. You slide the slots down, you push down like that. Now, before we screw the keyboard in, we want to put the ribbon on for the panel. So we're going to pull it back, and however your panel goes, grab your ribbon and flip up. This one has a flip up switch. We just put it back in there, the ribbon. Once you line it up, there we go. And push down. Usually the ribbons have a white line across and it shows you how far it needs to go in. It's pretty simple. Okay, that's that. We're gonna slide the keyboard down before we put this in, and we're gonna put our two screws in for the keyboard. And then before we put this panel in, we just got to put our covers for our LCD hinges and wires, and then that's it. We'll turn her on and see if she works. Okay, these are the two sides. Each one is different, so you gotta get them right. Wish I would have laid them out. All right, this one is gonna go right there. This one's gonna go right there. And then this one goes right, I believe right there. All right. And you see what I was saying about the wires. You have to get them lined up. Now, we're gonna wanna put our panel on. The rivets, wanna go down first. So we're gonna push the rivets down first to lock them in. If you get them lined up, it should pop in like butter. All right. And then we're just going to, once we get it lined up, you just want to kind of slide your finger down. If it doesn't look like it's all the way down, it isn't. So, here's the very first startup. I haven't even started it up myself. We're just going to hit the power button and see how it works. Oh, there we go. It's a little low light right now. And there you have it. Well guys, thanks for watching. How to replace your LCD screen on a laptop. This is a Gateway M1624 laptop, if you guys are wondering which version it was. And go ahead and subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time.